Hey guys, how are you going? It's Nikita Gaddy, Misfit Revolution, back at you with another video today. So, what have we got in store? It is my salted caramel recipe for my overnight oats. So, it's like kind of the same thing, but with a little twist on it. So, if you want to find out what we have here and how the hell we're going to combine these into one, then don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Hit the little notification bell so, of course, you can stay up to date with every single video that we upload. And as I always say, it would be downright upsetting if you miss anything that goes up or down on this channel. So, keep on watching. Finna run it up, 50 grand to blow, wish you ready. The mop, it is extremely still a little bit long at the front, and at the short is extremely short at the back, so it's just so much better. I feel like when I'm walking around, I'm just like just feels like I have nothing on my head, which is really odd for me because I have such thick, heavy, and just so much hair. So for me to not feel like I have hair on my head is like honestly a miracle. Okay, so how I kind of came up with this, how did it happen? I had started working with a new business partner of mine. She actually gave me one of these samples to try. It's from White Wolf Nutrition, and it's a vegan all-in-one pea protein packed with superfoods, salted caramel protein powder. So super exciting. Honestly, when I saw that, I was like, salted caramel is like my favorite. Salted caramel ice cream, salted caramel thick shakes, anything salted caramel is just to die for. Like, I'm so down. The first thing I thought of was overnight oats. I didn't even think to try it in a shake. I was like, nah, we're putting it in overnight oats. I need to change up my flavors. I've done chocolate, I've done peanut butter, done vanilla, done cinnamon, I've done everything. So I thought, why not get a salted caramel one going? So I feel like I've put together a good ratio of each. Of course, if you do make this yourself, then you can replace or minimalize or increase any percentage of what I put in, each to your own, which is no worries at all. So let's just jump straight into it. I'll first run through what we have, and then I'll start by adding them into the bowl. So first of all, of course, we've got almond milk. Definitely gonna need almond milk for your overnight oats, or you can use water, you can use full cream, you can use cashew milk, whatever your heart desires. I actually have used water before when I ran out of almond milk. I thought I had some and I actually had none at all, which I was so spewing. But I have used water and how did it come out? I think I just had to put less water because then it can make it really watery. But it came out fine from what I remember. But yeah, just try to don't put too much water, otherwise it can come out really runny. But this one is the So Good brand. It's actually almond and coconut milk. So I just find that it's the coconut milk with the almond milk just gives it that little bit of a sweeter taste, as opposed to having to buy sweetened almond milk or buying just coconut milk. I probably could just buy coconut milk, but I mean, they've got the option for both, so why not? So you're gonna need definitely that. You're gonna need, if you can find any salted caramel protein powder, or you can get, you can make like caramel sauce, or you can just buy like, I don't know, caramel flavor powder from the supermarket. But if you can get the salted caramel flavor in the protein, that would be better. Otherwise, then you're just having to add vanilla protein on top as well. So if you can, jump on and buy the White Wolf one. I will leave them in the description, and I'm sure you can grab as many as you like. You're also going to need, now these few are optional. I've got hemp seeds and poppy seeds, only because it's a good way just to add the extra nutrition. Overnight oats are a good way to do that, or like your little protein bars, or like salads and like soups and that. All those things where you're having to combine heaps of food into one is a great way to, like, you know, sneak your little ingredients in there that can obviously give you more nutritional value. And I mean, I'm not going to have these on their own, so if I can put it into a recipe, then that's always a good thing. So that, I always put those in my recipes, poppy seeds, or you can use black or white chia seeds. I just didn't have any chia seeds, so I'm going with poppy seeds. Definitely going to need cinnamon, so make sure you grab cinnamon ground. It's just the powder one. I'm sure you can get it in heaps of different brands and heaps of different forms, so just as long as you have some sort of cinnamon powder. And of course, our staple is oats. So I've just got Australian quick oats. It's certified organic, as raw as you can get. Try not to get ones with like mixed fruit or mixed nuts in there. Just get straight oats, so then you can add your own fruit or nuts in there if you want to. But yeah, just try to keep it minimal and as raw as possible. Now with this one, you can add a banana. The last time I did as well, I just used half a banana. But today I wanted to make it as raw as possible. Like with the chocolate one and like your peanut butter one, obviously you're putting peanut butter in there, you're putting like heaps of different other fruits and like additives and stuff. So if you can, if you want one that's more minimal, more easier, slip slop slab together, then this is your go-to, and it still tastes just as amazing. You're just grabbing a plain bowl, usually you're kind of like a lunch or dinner size, it just depends on how much you want to prep, but I'm only doing for today and tomorrow because today is Thursday, and by the time it sets tomorrow, it should leave me for tomorrow. If I eat it tomorrow and Saturday, and then at least I can make some more on Sunday for the new week. So I like to roughly, I mean, the more you make this, the more you'll find you won't have to measure out. But for the sake of the video, I'm going to measure about 2 cups. So this is 1 cup here. So I'm going to put 2 of these of the oats. So 1. Oh, will that be enough? I think that might be enough already. Okay, I changed my mind. I'm going to do 1.5 because I just realized I don't have enough protein of the salted caramel to put in. So that's another thing. Don't put, like, it's good to measure the first few times so you can make sure you're getting a good amount of everything. Obviously, once you get used to it, like I have for a while now, you can kind of just have a rough idea of what you can put more in and what you can put less in and whatnot. But because I only have 1 packet of the salted caramel today, I'm actually waiting on getting more. Then if I had another one, I'd just put 2 in. So 1.5, about halfway. In we go. So that can be put to the side. Next we're going to go in, almond milk always goes last, so I like to mix in all the powders and all the seeds in first before we actually put the almond milk in. So I'm just going to jump in and put the protein in straight away. So this is great, it's got like all your amino acids, it's got like really good plant-based ingredients as well. So let's just open. Oh, it smells so good, you have no idea. I literally just like after I have the shake, I'm just sit there and I'm just like, smells so good. Okay, so pour that whole thing in. Yum. Oh my gosh, I want to make a cake with this. I should make like a, oh, let me know if you guys want that. That would be really cool if you want a like I can do the salted caramel protein like muffins or like a cake or like, oh, pancakes, yum. I'll make them soon. That could be my next one. So moving on to cinnamon, I'll go 2 teaspoons. So I think of it 1 teaspoon as a leveled teaspoon. Some people think if it's got like a massive mountain on it, that's 1. But for me, it'll be leveled. So I'll just see, for me, that's like 1 teaspoon there, especially for powder, because it basically is like the whole thing's covered. So pouring that in, and we'll go again. And in we go. All right, moving on. We're gonna go with the poppy seeds. So I'm only gonna do 1 teaspoon because even though there's seeds, or like the hemp seeds as well, you can actually, like, I've done it once before and I put way too many and you could just taste it, like it just completely ruined the taste. So just put 1 teaspoon. I mean, obviously if you like it, then go for it. For me personally, I think that it just overrides the taste, if you ask me. And 1 teaspoon as well of the hemp seeds. These are so, so good for you, seriously. So that's what it looks like so far.
Super duper delicious, so colourful. And now we're just going to put the almond milk in and mix it together.
Alrighty, so lucky last step. Sorry, I had to duck inside, so now I'm back. Oh. Stay. Okay, so last step, we're going to go straight into almond and coconut milk. So like I said, you can use anything, actually. Finna run it up, 50 grand to blow, wish you ready. Spinning like a bird.
birthday girl, gon' blow the fatty. All the money in your Birkin bag, it can kinda help.
Hey, shake a bottle. Okay, it's probably gonna explode on me now. It didn't. Lucky. Alright, so I'm gonna say 2 cups because you definitely need either the water or the liquid to be leveled or that little bit more. So let's go 2 cups this time. Ooh, yum. 1 2A 3A whatever A. Alright. Cutie la lid. That we gonna fix that. We gonna mix it. So just slowly but surely. Yum, this is gonna taste so good. I can't wait to eat this, seriously. I wish it was like 1 hour oats so I could eat it today and not tomorrow. It smells so good already. I wish you could smell it through the screen, seriously. If you ever do recreate this, please tag me. I will leave all my information down below. Send me a photo, send me your, I really want to know your feedback as well. It's super important for me, not just to hear, but just so if anyone else has ideas, because obviously like when I'm working or when I'm, you know, doing programs or have clients or doing my recipes, like I only, like the person that's doing it only sees from their point of view or from, you know, their view or vision. So that's why I always love hearing feedback, whether it's good or bad, because it just opens your mind to, you know, other ways and other things to look at. So I might like this, you might think it tastes like shit. So let me know. Done. Doesn't look the most appealing at the moment, but I will show you what it looks like tomorrow morning. But it'll all be in the same video. So this is the finished recipe. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you like these recipe talk throughs, please let me know. I mean, I like to do a bit of both, but sometimes it's just good to chat, prep my food, get going, and have a laugh. So thanks for watching me prep it. I'm gonna pop it in the fridge for, it might be done by this tonight, but we're gonna play it safe and leave it for tomorrow morning. So I'll see yous for now and I'll catch yous tomorrow morning.
Let's watch this money line up. Roll a Fonto. We be getting cashed out from the Bay to Toronto. What you gonna do when the bag is too heavy? Finna run it up, 50 grand to blow, is you ready? Spend it like your birthday, girl, gon' blow the fatty. All the money in your Birkin bag, getting kinda heavy.